Very good afternoon to you, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Pranav, Pranav Pani, and I represent my company, Tan India Beyond Border Private Limited. This is my second company. The first one was MTMC Medi-Info Private Limited, which was acquired by the investors, so I started my second one, so I've been continuing with this. Besides this, being also, you know, the so-called startup mentor, you know, mentoring several startups across India. That really is something I'm enjoying to hear myself admit to you. Because I'm learning what I could not in my entire career of 27 years in the corporate sector, and then from 2012 onwards as the entrepreneur, I think I'm learning much more while I'm interacting with the, particularly the youngsters, you know, with bright ideas and phenomenal minds. So that's about it, and I also happen to be a writer. I've already written two books. My third one is about to be published. So talking about this, like I said, it's a learning process, you know. At the age of 56 years, so I'm learning and really enjoying my life. This phase in life is fantastic. And I'm sure today will be a great opportunity, thanks to the organizers and meeting such, I call it BIMs, so that's bright young minds. You know, the beautiful bright young minds are something which inspire. I mean, it's not like somebody with gray hair like us would be inspiring, probably not, with the generation changing and going in a different direction. What's very important is the observation in life. You know, when you're talking about any kind of entrepreneurship, like today, I've been asked to talk about social venture. Well, actually, very correctly said, unfortunately, when you talk about it, it's like mostly getting tagged with, you know, not for profit. Unfortunately, in this part of the world, in India in particular, anything related to profit is being looked down upon. I mean, come on, I mean, you have to do business. I mean, it's not a, even if the kind of charity, you need money to fund for it. How do you sustain otherwise? Now, if that's the kind of challenge you have, how do you manage the whole ecosystem? You need to develop an ecosystem, the support ecosystem, which is very important for the sustainability, which is missing. Even if you talk about the kind of grants available, $1 billion of grants people are talking about, several industries here, corporates, but then why? My question, I'm here as an entrepreneur, I'm asking this question, why then most of the bright minds are struggling with, you know, phenomenal, brilliant ideas, not getting the kind of funds that you're talking about. I'm talking about even you might have heard about an organization from Bhubaneswar. Well, I'm basically from Odisha, so probably that's an example that comes to my mind exactly. It's called Kalinga Institute of Social Sciences, KISS, which is being run by a gentleman called Dr. Achyuta Samant. And since I happen to know him very closely, and I've been observing how this has become a phenomenal, you know, kind of a role model in business, which has been appreciated across the globe. Not a single country's president or prime minister have not visited that place. They come to Bhubaneswar not to meet the governor or the chief minister, but then they insist on visiting this place where 25,000 tribal boys and girls are being taught absolute free from KG to PG. You have this student called Duti Chand, the sprinter, international sprinter from India, Duti Chand. 100 meter. She's a student of that. Similar thing, the current Indian hockey captain, Nilima Minj, she's from that piece, you know, from archery, rugby, about five of the students are in national team. And the sports I'm talking about. The first student from that place has got selected for the Indian Civil Services recently. So, do you think that's the kind of transformation? And people question him, like, where does he, you know, arrange for the funds? 25,000. National Geography had shown it in the Mega Kitchen. The first episode was based on that, where every day, twice a day, 25,000 students sit on the floor, massive floor, and with one of the most hygiene kitchen that we have in the country, serve them instantly every day without any difficulties. They have the best of gyms, they have the best of swimming pool, they have the whatnot like. Now that's the social transformation that we're talking about. That is required where he's getting, he has another engineering institute called KIT, K-I-I-T. 5% of the profit he transfers to this KISS. Plus he gets lots of grants and from across the world literally. Now, it is, if you physically go across there, I mean, I can vouch for it, you'll see how a major transformation is being generated over there. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's very important, like coming back to again the same issue of the profit. When you are struggling with a brilliant idea, because basically there is a gap between the demand and supply, or you want to alleviate the situation in the society, whether it's in healthcare, whether it's in environment, whether it's in anything for that matter, anything under the sun. But then, the important thing is, how do you do that? You have a tremendous, beautiful idea. But then while implementing, you come across, you experience lots of roadblocks, lots of challenges. The entire journey is full of potholes, like what we experience daily in Bangalore roads. Similar kind of thing. You trip down on that and then you get up again, bruise and you know, that kind of situation, but then the spirit is something which sustains and pushes you along. But then how long? Why would you struggle having such a brilliant idea which is going to change and transform the society, at least the segment of the society which you are targeting at? Now, the biggest thing which is missing out here, I'm sure to be more learned people out here would throw some light on that, is a creation of a support ecosystem. It's vital for the sustainability. So last probably 15-20 days I've been interacting with many of my friends in the UK and US and Australia and the three places in particular. And their question is, particularly the Indian ones, they do not accept it, they do not believe when I claim that, you know, this is the kind of scenario we have in India with the startup entrepreneurs doing phenomenal things. It's a no. Unfortunately for us, the kind of story that we come across are all copycats. It's a success story which is being there in US, UK, Australia, Canada, is just being replicated, customized to the need of you know, the country. Why can't we have something absolutely innovative? Well, that's a valid question, that's a pertinent question, definitely. I mean, we need to ask each other. But then when you're talking about changing and transforming a particular scenario in the society, and particularly if you're talking about the social transformation, you know, the biggest challenge that we have, we're talking about the poverty line. Now, there have been several ways of measuring GDP, you know, or the politicians, are very smart enough to play around with those numbers, and we get totally confused. But then, put that aside, the issue here is, are we really developing? What is the definition of that? What kind of development that we are talking about? I mean, is it been defining in such a manner that it has to be visible, tangible? You can feel it, you can experience it. But more important is, the changes need to happen in a way keeping pace with the rapid changes across the globe, particularly as far as technology is concerned. Now, technology is also a boon, which, if utilized effectively, any of the idea that you have is going to supplement that, and it's going to definitely elevate to the next level. But then again, the biggest question, you know, where most of the startup entrepreneurs, and particularly in the social sector, you know, social venture, they get stuck the moment you ask the question on scaling up the business model. Now, there is a question. I mean, I being on the other side as a not just a mentor, but then while evaluating this kind of elevator pitch by the startup companies sometime back in Bombay, I had a difference of opinion with the fellow investor. The kind of question he asked, I feel very bad. I mean, in the sense, it's not like sitting on this side of the table. Even I happen to sit the other side of the table, the opposite side of the table as an entrepreneur. So I could see from that point of view, how does it feel being an entrepreneur and being questioned this kind of thing, which really irritates even the entrepreneur. And someone, unfortunately, talks straight absolutely on this. I do not feel like beating about the bush and with a sugar-coated tongue to please someone. No. The fact is, if you need to help someone, professionally even, put it across the moment you are convinced. Biggest problem what happens, if I'm an investor, I accept everything of your business model, but then where I stop is I do not prefer to share the risk. Now my question to the investor there is, if you're convinced about the business model, if you're convinced about the numbers that you're talking about and see in the balance sheet, and you're taking equity share and all that, you know, everything is loaded in your favor. Now look at the poor guy who's shelling out money from his pocket, quit his cushy job, and still struggling, and tomorrow something goes wrong, you would like to dump into the drain and wash your hands off him, because you do not want to. Then what's the difference between a lender and an investor? I'm sorry, I'm not be talking anything very technical. This is what I think we come across every day. Now, these are the kind of challenges, but still in spite of that, I must thank each of you who has been continuing with this kind of spirit. You know, that's something very important, the kind of spirit that needs to push you along in this kind of muddy and stony road. But the issue here is, the moment you're talking about convincing on particularly your social venture, basic idea is to elevate a particular situation. Whether you want to elevate poverty, education, healthcare, environment, economy, or anything for that matter. Now, what segment of that you are targeting is something you need to be very, very clear about. I'm sure it's not like across the board that you're looking at and a major canvas that you have which you would like to address, you cannot. All right, because the kind of challenges that you have, particularly with the funding and the sustainability, and more importantly, is the scaling up your business, taking to the next level. Where? How? Is the biggest question. Third, when you are giving a presentation to the investor, how do you quantify? Now, the biggest challenge over here is that a tangible thing? Can you put a number against it? That yes, this is the kind of impact it will have. Fine, impact I've understood. In numbers, can you put it across and give it to me? If that would be my question, would you have an answer to that? Please be clear about that. It's a very tough thing when in social venture in particular, if the investor asks you to put a particular number on to justify the word impact, that is where you face lots of challenges. It's a debatable thing. Having said that, I would still say there is a tremendous opportunity available today in particular. There have been corporates who have really come forward to support these kind of things, even quite a few organizations, even the government and many overseas funding agencies. Only thing is, you need to know, like probably NSR cell kind of organizations to support you, help you in that. But most important, I would request all of you, you come together, create your own platform. Because most important thing, particularly if you're talking about not just being a normal general entrepreneur, but even in social venture, we miss out on a very valid and important point, which is collaboration. If you could identify, you could find a common synergy with another company doing a similar kind of social venture, I'm pretty sure you can leverage on that, you can collaborate and support each other. There have been instances which I've personally come across, and I'm convinced today that you need to collaborate. Gone are the days when it's all, you know, hero worship kind of thing. Single-handedly would like to do something. You can, definitely. But the more important is if you collaborate, your journey becomes much easier and the road that you'll be traveling will be much smoother for you. Now, third thing I would like to emphasize on is the use of technology. Now, use of technology, which are the kind of technology? It's not just that today we think everyone is talking about artificial intelligence, so machine learning, IoT, whatnot. But will that be beneficial for you is what you need to identify. But one biggest byproduct which many of the people, particularly the social venture, miss out on, and that's my personal observation while meeting the entrepreneurs, is the humongous amount of data which gets generated. Trust me, believe me, if you can focus on that, there's no end to, there's no, I mean, there's definitely there's no dearth of ideas, but then if you could identify and start analyzing your data, you could create lots of things from the same thing. If you're talking about something related to agriculture, the kind of data if you have, if you know how you can sell yourself to the companies related to the agriculture industry, they are the people who are going to buy it from you directly. But it has to be, you need to analyze the whole thing. You need to, bring out kind of a solution out of it. That could be sold as a product. That is a quantifying ideas, which definitely fetches numbers. I'm very, very much convinced about it. So you need to have data analytic in that. It's very, very important. The moment you start doing it, I can assure you, if I would be interacting with you tomorrow, I can even tell you and guide you like how beneficial it's going to be. Probably wouldn't have cited in your business radar. But the amount of benefit that you will accrue from that will be tremendous. So all the very best to all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, I think I've taken a lot of your time. In fact, I've come here, like I said, to learn and listen to all of you. And who knows, my selfish desire, probably I could open up another entrepreneurship business tomorrow, getting inspired by all of you. And it's a tremendous effect with lots of excitement. I'm waiting for the great musician, Mr. Richie Case. And it's going to be a phenomenal experience, I'm sure. All the very best to you all, bright minds here. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.